Hare Krishna. Welcome back to the study of the 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. We are in the first chapter and we discussed till now the first 13 verses. So let's have an overview of what is happening before we move forward. So in the first 13 verses, initially the verses 1 to 4, Parikshit Maharaj, basically the first 13 verses are a request to Shukadeva Goswami by Parikshit Maharaj that please speak elaborately the pastimes of Krishna that you have mentioned briefly just now. That means in the last chapter of the 9th canto, that is 9.24. Now, within these 13 verses, there are sections. So first 4 verses talk about the general glories of Krishna's pastimes and how they benefit everyone. So there is a famous one, Nirutta Tarshay Rupagiyamanad. And he says, because they are beneficial to everyone, please speak those pastimes. And then verses 5, 6, 7, he talks about how I have also a personal and special relationship with Krishna. Krishna protected my grandfather and Krishna protected me also. So he is very dear to me. Please speak about him. Then in verses 8 to 11, Parikshit Maharaj asks specific questions. He asks questions such as, you know, why did, how could the same child have been born in two places? Why, that is referring to Balram, or how Krishna, why did Krishna leave his father and go away after birth? Why did Krishna kill his own maternal uncle? So, based on any story we hear, if there are interesting twists and turns, we want to know about the further about those twists and turns. So that's what he's asking over there. And in 12th and 13th verses, he speaks to Shukadeva Goswami, please do not cut it short. Please elaborate. So 12th verse is elaborate, and 13th verse he says, don't feel that I am distracted because of hunger and thirst. No, as long as you are speaking, that is far more nourishing for me. So now, from the 14th verse onwards, first Suta Goswami speaks, and when he speaks, he talks about the glory of both the speaker and the hearer. So the Bhagavatam is a set of nested conversations. So the outer conversation starts in the first canto, first chapter, first canto, first chapter is Suta Goswami is speaking to the Naimisharani sages. And then from the towards the last verses of the first canto, the 19th chapter, and then there Parikshit Maharaj asks some questions. And from there onwards, the Shukadeva Goswami Parikshit Maharaj question answer starts. So here, Suta Goswami is narrating this conversation, speaks the glories of both the speaker and the hearer. Then after that, Shukadeva Goswami starts speaking from 15th verse. And first, when he speaks, he appreciates Parikshit Maharaj for his wonderful questions. Then in the 16th verse, he also appreciates and glorifies Krishna Katha. How it is so wonderful and why, how it is beneficial hearing that and speaking that. So he says, actually it will benefit me also. He is expressing out of his humility. And then after that, 17th verse onwards, till the 20th verse, he starts describing, so from 17th verse onwards, actually starts describing the pastime of the appearance of Krishna. So 17th to 20 is describing how earth goes to Brahmaji and Brahmaji goes to Brahmaji along with the earth and the devatas goes to Vishnu. And then from 21st to 25th verse, Brahmaji is conveying the message that Vishnu gave through the devatas, through Brahmaji to the devatas. So his message and his instructions. So this is how the flow is going through. Now let us start with the 14th verse, which we will be discussing now.
Suta uvacha evam nishamya bhrugunandana saduvadam vayasakesa bhagavanatha vishnuratam pratyarcha krishna charitam kalikalma shagnam vyahartum arabhat bhagvat pradhanaha.
So Suta Goswami glorifies Shukadev Goswami and Parikshit Maharaj both. So he glorifies Parikshit Maharaj as Vishnuratam. So one who is absorbed in Vishnu, one who has been accepted by Vishnu, one who is loved by Vishnu. So this name has come right in the first canto also. So he's the questioner and the hearer is also a great soul, is to be appreciated. And then his questions are sadhuvadam. They are excellent questions. They are questions about Krishna which will reveal Krishna's glories to the world. And then he glorifies, he uses four describers to glorify Shukadev Goswami. So it's Bhrugunandana. Sorry, Bhrugunandana is not a glorification of Shukadev Goswami. He is praising even his audience. He is talking about Shamik Rishi. And actually, Shamik Rishi is a Brahmana and is a descendant of Bhrugu. So he is connected with Bhrugu and therefore he says Bhrugunandana. The word Nandana at one level means sun. Nandana also means one who gives happiness. So normally a son is meant to give happiness. So Bhrugunandana, he's saying, Shamik Rishi, I'm going to speak to you, Bhrugunandana, what was spoken over there. And then he uses three references or three names to refer to the speaker, that is Sukadeva Goswami. So Vyasaki. Vyasaki is the son of Vyasadeva. And then what is his characteristic? He is saying he is Bhagavat Pradhanaha. He is the greatest among the Bhagavatas, the topmost devotee. So now, Shukadeva Goswami is such a great devotee because he is so vastly learned and realized that even the greatest saints and sages of the universe are hearing from him. And we know that he went through impersonal realization, got that realization and found that that was unfulfilling. And when he came to the realization, when he heard Krishna's pastimes, when he found them so overwhelmingly attractive, that he left the impersonal path, impersonal Brahman, and rose to Bhagavan realization. So he's a very exalted devotee. And further, he's glorified also here as Bhagavan. So now, the word Bhagavan has multiple meanings. The standard meaning which Srila Prabhupada explains to us is one who is having six opulences. So that is Bhagavan definitely. But along with that, there are also other meanings. Now we see these other meanings being referred to even in the Bhagavatam. So Bhagavan Badarayana or Bhagavan Shiva. So many great saints and sages are also referred to as Bhagavan. Why is that? Because Bhagavan is present in their heart and Bhagavan is manifesting through their heart. Bhagavan is... they are so close to Bhagavan that from the point of view of their actions, they are acting on behalf of Bhagavan, doing His will, so speaking His message. So in that sense, they are non-different from Him. So when Bhagavan is present in some great devotees' hearts and He speaks through them, then they are also called as Bhagavan. So here Sanatan Goswami quotes the famous verse from the 9th canto, the Ambarish Maharaj pastime, where Lord Vishnu is telling Sadhavam Hridayam Mayam Sadhunam Hridayam Tadaham Madanyate Na Janati Naham Tebhyo Managapi. So he says that the devotee, the Lord is present in the heart of the devotee, and the devotee is present in the heart of the Lord. The Lord knows no one except the devotee, and the devotee knows anyone except the Lord. This is a very intimate relationship between both of them. And in this relationship, the Lord practically is non-different. So, in that sense, the devotees can also be referred to as Bhagavan. And additionally, Sanatan Goswami also quotes another reference which gives a different definition of Bhagavan. So, he quotes from the Vishnu Purana. He says, who is Bhagavan? Utpattim pralayam chaiva bhutanam agatim gatim vetti vidvam avidvam cha Savacho Bhagavaniti, Savacho Bhagavaniti. That person is called as Bhagavan who knows all these things. What does he know? He knows of Utpattim Pralayam Chaiva. He knows about the creation and destruction of the universe. Bhutanam Agatim Gatim. So, that person knows how the living entities are created, how they their material bodies are destroyed. And one who knows vidyam and avidyam, one who knows knowledge and nations. So one who knows all these things, means material knowledge, spiritual knowledge, knows about creation, destruction of material world and of the living entities. So that means one who has expansive knowledge, that knowledge is also an opulence of Krishna, and one who manifests that expansive knowledge is also can also be called as Bhagavan. So this is an alternative definition of Bhagavan. Savachyo Bhagavaniti. Now after that, the most significant word here is Kali Kalmashagnam. So Kali Kalmasha. So the contamination of Kali. Kali Yuga. So now Sanatana Goswami says that this word can have four different meanings. Kali Kalmashagnam. So Krishna Katha, when we hear it, it destroys the contaminations of Kali. How? By defeating Kali himself. So Kali is the root of sins. When Kali gets defeated, then the contaminations automatically get defeated. That is how is Kali Kalmashagnam, Krishna Katha. Another explanation is that the primary characteristic of Kali is Kalaha, quarrel. Dispute, and one primary dispute is about the nature of the absolute truth, the nature of the sadhya and the sadhana. But when Krishna Katha is heard, then by that hearing of Krishna Katha from authorized sources, one becomes clear. One understands this is sadhya, one this is sadhana, this is tattva. When we understand like this, then the spiritual message becomes supremely relishable. And conflicts disappear. The Bhagavatam says that when the Lord disappears from the heart, then conflicts appear. And when the Lord appears in the heart, then conflicts become transcended. In Krishna, conflicts are reconciled and contradictions are reconciled and transcended. So this is how, by hearing Krishna Katha, the Kalaha, the characteristic of Kali Yuga, the primary contamination of Kali Yuga is quarrel. So that Kalaha is destroyed. And Krishna Katha brings us the knowledge of Tattva. Then hypocrisy also gets destroyed. Because when one understands the truth, then those who are pretenders, claiming to know the truth, they also get exposed. A third meaning of Kali Kalmasha, he says, is that actually it does both. It that hearing Krishna Katha removes the Kalmasha, removes the contaminations that are there in our heart. And it removes the influence of Kali. So in this way, the sin and the root of sin, both are destroyed by Krishna Katha. And further, he says that this can refer, instead of Krishna Charita, this adjective, Kali Kalmashagna, this describer, can be used to refer to Vishnuradha, that is Parikshit Maharaj. That means that Parikshit Maharaj, as we know, he defeated Kali. So, as long as he was present, Kali could not have his influence. So, therefore, Kali Kalmashagna can also refer to Parikshit Maharaj. And Vyaharthum Aravad Bhagavat Pradhana. So, we Aravata. That means, he began. Arambha, we say, began. So, what did do? What happened? When this Shukadeva Goswami, Parikshit Maharaj stopped speaking, then Shukadeva Goswami started speaking. And now, it's like the camera, so if we have the camera, first the camera is focused on the inner narrative of the camera of the Bhagavatam. Now, temporarily the camera goes back to the outer narrative, and then again it will return to the inner narrative. So here, let us look at the next verse which Shukadeva Goswami will speak now. Now, especially Shukadeva Goswami is glorified because the glorious devotees, they are so exalted that by associating with them, by hearing from them, their bhakti gets infused in our heart. So, by remembering the glories of those whom we are hearing from, we feel more inspired, knowing that we will also become spiritually advanced by associating with them, hearing from them. In Bhagavatam, there are many examples. Parikshit Prahlad Maharaj's friends, schoolmates, were actually demoniac. But by hearing from him, they became purified. By hearing from Srila Prabhupada, so many people who had such terrible contamination, they all became purified. So this is the potency of Krishna Katha. And remembering, meditating on the glory of the speaker can inspire us to go to shelter of Krishna and thereby infuse ourselves with bhakti. Sri Shuka Vacha,
सम्यक् व्यवसिता बुद्धिस् तव राज ऋषि सत्तमा वासुदेव कथायां ते यज्जाता नैष्ठिकीरति.
सो ही इज टेलिंग दैट ओ परीक्षित महाराज, योर इंटेलिजेंस इज वेरी स्ट्रांगली डेवलप्ड, इट्स फिक्स्ड वन पॉइंट एंड देयर बाय नाउ यू, दिस इज एविडेंस्ड इन द फैक्ट दैट यू हैव गॉट नैष्ठिकीरति, यू गॉट स्ट्रांग अट्रैक्शन फॉर वासुदेव कथा. So let's look at the words one by one. Vyavasita buddhi. Vyavasayatmika buddhi. Krishna uses in 2.41 in the Bhagavad Gita. So your buddhi has become fixed. There Krishna is telling, do this as an instruction. This is what we should do. And here he is telling, this has been done. Vyavasita buddhi. And he is glorifying Parikshit Maharaj by a very special this epithet. Is Raj Rishi Sattama. So there are many rishis. And there are Raj Rishis, so they are very exalted. Now they are the Rishi refers to the inner seer, the Raja refers to the outer ruler. So they have the marriage of the seer and the ruler, and then they can do great goods to the world. And Parikshit Maharaj is such a great devotee, but among such Raj Rishis, he's Sattama, he's the greatest of the devotees. Why? Because he is so absorbed in Krishna, even at the time of death, and he is eagerly asking questions. Now this verse, of course, while referring to Shukadeva Goswami, uses reference Shri Shuka Vacha. So the Shri is added because what Shukadeva Goswami speaks is going to be very sweet. One of the characteristics of Shri is Lakshmi Devi is very sweet, and Shri Shuka. So just as a parrot speaks very sweetly, Shukadeva Goswami is speaking Krishna Katha in a very sweet way. The content is sweet, the voice is also sweet. And then he's saying, Jati Naishthiki Ratihi, that Rati is Naishthiki. So there is no distraction. And this is amazing. Normally, bodily conveniences, inconveniences, things distract us from Krishna. But he's saying that there is no distraction for Parikshit Maharaj. And he uses this indication that your consciousness is fixed. So he appreciates Parikshit Maharaj does. And then he says that he himself has got prema. So now Parikshit Maharaj is referred to in different ways at different times. But here he is appreciating Parikshit Maharaj in a special way. Raj Rishi Sattama. Then now he glorifies Krishna Katha. And this is also a well-known verse which Prabhupada would quote. 16th verse, Vasudeva katha prashnaha purusham strin punatihi vaktaram prachakam shotrims tatpad salilam yatha. So, Vasudeva katha prashnaha. The questions about Lord Krishna's pastimes, they purify three people. Purusham strin punatihi, purify. So, vaktaram is the speaker. Prachakam is one who is asking the question. And Shrotrim. So all three get purified. And Tatpad Salilam Yatha. So Tatpad. We know that Ganga Devi, she emanates from the lotus feet of Vishnu. Of the Supreme Lord. Charan Sindhu Dekhiya Ganga Sukhsa Seema Paaye. Bhaktivinoda Thakur says in his Vaishnava Gita that Charan Sindhu, that Ganga is coming from the lotus feet of the Lord. So Tatpad Salilam Yatha. So just as the Ganga, it comes from the lotus feet of the Lord, and it purifies the higher world, the middle world, and even the lower worlds. It goes through all the universe. So like that, when Krishna Katha purifies everyone. So he elaborates further that, he gives an example, if there is very sacred water, either Ganga Jal, or if somebody worships Shaligram Shila and the water is there, the sprinkler, the water is sprinkled on a person who asks requests for that sprinkling. Then while the water is sprinkled, some of the sprinkled water falls on the person who is sprinkling. Some water falls on the person who has asked, requested to be sprinkled. And it falls on others also. So, who are nearby. So, similarly, Krishna Katha benefits the speaker, questioner and other hearers also. And he says, how is the speaker benefited? Because the speaker also connecting with Krishna, remembering Krishna, and that is purifying. And the questioner asks, the speaker's position as the speaker gets established. So even that itself, because he's going to speak about Krishna, that itself is purifying. And further, speaks about Krishna, helps other souls come to Krishna, closer to Krishna, that also purifies. So he's appreciated Parikshit Maharaj, now he's appreciated Krishna Katha, and now he will start the narrative.
Bhumir dripta nripa vyaja daityanikshata yutai akranta bhuri bharena brahmanam sharanam yayau.
So here is telling Bhumir drupta drupa vyaja. Drupa is kings. Bhumir drupta is intoxicated with pride. Bhumir. So these were kings who were ruling the earth, but they were tyrannical rulers. And daityani kshatayutai, and they were extremely powerful. Kshatayutai, they have many, many hundreds and thousands of phalanxes. Innumerable soldiers they had. And akranta bhuri bharena. So troubled by this burden. So Mother Earth, she being troubled by the person, Brahmanam sharanam yayau. So what did you do? She went to Brahman to take shelter, to ask, beg for relief. Why Brahma? Brahmaji is, we know, at the ultimate level, at the administrative level, local matters, for that Indra is the chief of the Devatas. But for emergency situations, then even Indra has to go sometimes to Brahma. So similarly here, Bhumi Devi saw that this was an emergency. And because of that, I have to go to the Lord. So I have to go to Brahmaji. He is the person who have to consult during emergencies. So if a normal problem, sometimes we may just consult a local doctor, a local physician. But if we have a serious problem, then we have to go to a specialist. So, of course, the supreme specialist is Krishna, but Krishna has to be approached through his devotee. So, Bhumi Devi is herself a devotee, but she is going to Brahmaji, and he is exalted devotee, and he has contact with Krishna, and he is the appointed person who acts as a via media, and Bhumi Devi goes there. So now, the Drupta, they were intoxicated. What was the intoxication? They were intoxicated with pride, and because of which they would not respect the devotees. They would consider, they were violating dharma, they were tormenting people in general, and even the saintly who were trying to bring them on good path, they're not ready to listen to them also. Therefore, it was an emergency.
So, Gaurab, 18th verse, Gaurab bhutva shrumukhi khinna krandanti karunam vibho. Upasthit antike tasmai vyasanam samavochata.
So, Gaura. So, she took the form of a cow. And Bhutva
Ashrumukhi Khinna.
Her eyes were filled with tears. Khinna, he was rejected. Krandanti karunam vibho. And crying pitiably. And vibho.
So, the vibho word means great. Sometimes it can refer to the Supreme Lord. And other times it can refer to those who are great. By His grace. So, Brahmaji is extremely powerful, being the creator of the universe. And as she stood in front of Him, Upasthitantike tasmai vyasanam samavochata. She spoke her misery. Some vyasanam, her distress she spoke about. So, the further speech of the earth is described in the Harivamsha as well as in the Vishnu Puran, and a beautiful phrase is used over there. Khedat karuna bhashini. So she was speaking khedat, in misery, in distress, in regret, lamentation. Karuna bhashini. Pityably she was speaking, please help. So she's begging for help. So there's the distress of the Bhumi Devi is the trigger for the Lord to appear. You know, in all narratives, there is of many stories, there is a damsel in distress. So, and then some hero comes and rescues the damsel from distress. So, Bhumi Devi, she is female. She is taking the form of a cow. The cow is also considered to be very, very valuable, sacred. And her distress is intolerable. So, Bhumi Devi, she takes the form of a cow. That is what happened in the first canto. Also, we see Bhumi Devi taking the form of a cow. In the fourth canto, also in the Prithu Maharaj pastime, first canto in the conversation between Dharma as the bull and Bhumi Devi
as the cow, and Parikshit Maharaj comes over there. So he takes the form of a cow, because cow is considered to be a primary manifestation of the earth resource, a very valuable earth resource. And of course, cow is very dear to Krishna. Cow evokes emotion, tender emotions in the heart. So to evoke those emotions in the Supreme Lord, Bhumi Devi, manifests in the form of a cow. And she is talking about all the various demons who have been oppressing her. And there are many, many demons. We will see later on who are those demons. And now what happens? Now she speaks to Brahma. Then Brahma with the devtas will go to Kshirasagar. Brahma tat upadharyatha sahadevaistaya saha jagam satrinayanas tiram kshirapayonidhe. So, taking the earth, dharya, upadharyatha, sahadevais. So, it took the devtas also with them. It was an emergency and the devtas were also concerned. And along with that, Trinayanas is the person with three eyes, that is Lord Shiva. So, Lord Shiva is also an exalted devotee. And his presence would invoke the response of the Lord. Because so many great devotees are coming, then the Lord will be concerned. And also because it's a huge emergency, which even Lord Shiva cannot solve. And even he is concerned. So he also comes along. And Brahmaji goes with all of them. Jagam. And where did they go? Tiram Kshirapayonidhe. Went to Tiram, the coast of the Kshirasagar. Payonidhe. So in the Vishnu Sahasranam and Padma Puran, one of the names that is used for Lord Vishnu is Vishnu Kshirabdhi Mandira. Vishnu is, what is his character? His mandira, his abode is Kshirabdhi in the Kshirasagar. And they went to the Tira, they went to the coast. You know, actually, he has his own abode on Anantashesha in the Kshirasagar. That is not so easily accessible. So Brahmaji could not go to that abode. He just went to the Tira, the coast of the ocean. And from there, he approached the Lord and he begged to the Lord. So here, further, now what happened? Tatra gatva jagannatham deva devam vrishakapim purusham purushasuktena uptasthe samahitaha. So what happened? He begged to the Lord jagannatham. That Lord Jagannath, he begged deva deva. He is the Lord of the Lords, the God of the Gods. None of them can, nobody else can help the way the Lord can help. So they went, and then what happened? Vrushakapi. Vrushakapi is a special name. So Vrusha is Varsha. So he actually gives a shower of blessings by which he fulfills the desires and akampayati. And that which is kampa, that is causing distress, trouble, he removes that. And in that way, he is the benedictor. So, Vrushakapi is referred. So, this reference indicates that they had a desire, they had a distress which they wanted to be mitigated, to be removed. So, Vrushakapi. And then, Purusham Purushasuktena. They praise the Lord with the Purushasukta. The Purushasukta is a very important set of verses. It describes the Lord with his thousands of hands and in his vibhuti, his glory. It describes so. That is how his mercy can be invoked and then his response will manifest. So thank you. We'll continue the next class. Hare Krishna.